I think the people who are going to cure cancer are going to be the people who have computational skills. If people have programming skills that can jump on and be a part of this, and that's what we want. We want to get everyone involved. We really think that the solution to unlocking cancer is really going to be from all of us.
The Fred Hutchinson Cancer Research Center is a research center in Seattle that specializes in understanding cancer and coming up with new cures that we can use for patients with diseases that are uncurable.
Our goal is to both research the cancer biology, but also treat patients. So we're part of a consortium that includes hospitals, but it also includes a large number of researchers.
Historically, when people were trying to decide what a cancer type was, they would look under a microscope. And because of the way things look, they would give it a name. But recently, we've had the ability to sequence huge amounts of DNA. And so all of a sudden, there's a whole lot more sort of digital data that completely describes a tumor in a much better way than simply the way a microscope would. This is both a good thing and a bad thing. It poses a problem in that the amount of data for any given person is enormous. And all that information has to be compiled together in some giant database and then manipulated and visualized. And so we were able to get a team together to attack this problem. And we've built some of these tools that we're pretty happy with.
Oncoscape is an open source web application where we take a cancer patient's information and we easily visualize it for doctors and scientists to understand what's going on in the patient's disease. The fields right now, there's cancer biologists, so the people who are studying cancer, and then there's the computational people. And so we wanted a tool that really could speak to both groups, and then at that same time is how can we make them work together.
My work includes dry lab, computational side, plus the wet lab, which means processing human tissues. So I work on both sides. So the tissue is freezed. I'll just put it on the dry ice and then switch to my thermal glove. A lot of times we only look at data as a computer scientist, but you don't know how the data were generated. And I have this opportunity to look at the tissue. And when the data doesn't make sense, then you go back to the specimen. Every aspect matters to generate good quality data. There's a lot of advantages to be able to work on both sides.
Well, I've been in this field for 20 years. I've learned more about the disease that I particularly am interested in, which is brain cancer, with simply this visualization tool, and I've learned over many of the previous years, because I'm not necessarily looking at only what the streetlight is illuminating. If you look at all the DNA, it's like turning the lights on in the entire room, and you see everything, and you see it all at once, and you can see the things that you know exist, but then there's all these other stuff that you didn't even know to look for, but it's sitting right in front of you.
So we wanted Oncoscape to be open source because our goal from the beginning has really been about collaboration. This year we got this idea because someone contacted us whose father had lung cancer, but he really didn't have a way to help except for programming. And it really gave us this idea that coders out there could really help us. And so we thought this would be a great thing to put on GitHub, and we felt like we could still give credit to people and use their name and really celebrate them for helping us in this fight against cancer.
You don't have to be an expert in biology or computational biology. We want to allow people to be an expert in their own field. And so we've created all these help wanted tasks of things that we're not experts at, that you might be an expert at. And we want our GitHub repository to be a place where people can come to and contribute their own knowledge, their own software, and their own efforts.
I know just by far how much I've been learning from the GitHub community. I've been checking out a lot of the repositories, just looking at how they code. We cannot work as competitors anymore in the cancer research because people die. So we really need to work together with different cancer centers, with different fields, with people from different expertise.
it's a very exciting time if these tools can be really brought to the level that just any old person could do this, and then, you know, it sort of opens up science and cancer research to everybody, which is actually really exciting.
I don't know. I mean, cancer will be solved on a computer. We want people to join us in making a tool that really all of us can benefit from.